story.
Mr. Steadman's about to discover there's more to life than being alive, because technically speaking...
I'm not claiming to be Alan Steadman, I am Alan Steadman.
He's, dead.
Apparently you're dead again.
Caroline Quentin, Robert Bathurst, Lenny Henry and John Corden Sinclair. Goodbye, Mr. Steadman. Sunday 9:20, ITV1.
Don't just sit there. You could save up to 20% on motor insurance. Buy online at directline.com or pick up the phone now.
I'll take those.
Oi!
Here you go. Clear off. 74 packets of Walker's crisps, please.
Walker's money bags are back. See if you can get your hands on a £20 note.
So as I said, the first five cards are the most significant.
Have a break. Have a KitKat.
It's a matter of taste. That's what makes you different. The things you desire. How you view the world. The way you live. And shape your surroundings. Like this Gabrielle three-seater sofa. In lilac. With beach legs. At only £399. Define your life. At Home Furnishing Outlet. Cannon Park, Middlesbrough.
A Bucks Fizz reception, four-course meal, Las Vegas cabaret show and dancing for 2,000 to 2,000 people from only £27.50 per person. Book Tall Trees for Christmas on 01642 387 100.
At Storey Carpets, we've got this beautiful warm and welcome carpet for only Storey Carpets. Giving prices a good beating every day.
They thought it was over.
We all went through it, Jack.
They thought they caught the right man.
Guilty.
They didn't think it could happen again.
What are you saying?
Young woman been murdered.
Starring Russ Kemp and Kenneth Cranham, a new series of Without Motive, Thursday at 9.
Then after the news at 10 this Thursday, Trevor McDonald brings you all the latest stories behind the headlines in the Tonight programme from 10:20. But now an unexpected visit for Declan.
This is about your milk. I'm really sorry, okay? I was dying for a cup of tea this morning. What?
Eamon, you've got a visitor.
Who?
It's your father.
Yeah?
Yeah. Do you want me to stay? Are you going to be all right?
Yeah. No, I don't know. What should I do?
I think you should go and say hello to him. Look, I'll be on the mobile if you need me, all right?
Hello, Dad.
Hello, son. How are you?
Fine. And yourself?
All right. My goodness, you've filled out there.
So have you.
Your friend there, Kath. Now, the last time I saw her, she had spikes in her hair and makeup like a raccoon. She looks lovely now, though.
She does, yeah.
Are you two married?
No.
Oh, that's okay, son. Things have changed, haven't they? Do you have any children yourself?
No.
Ah, plenty of time for that. It's good to see you, son.
And you too, Dad. Would you like a cup of tea?
Well, that'd be good. On second thoughts, we could always go to the pub.
So why exactly did the other tutor drop out?
Well, he wasn't well.
Evening,
Stuart.
What do you mean, well? Sore throat, broken leg,
no,
or...?
No, he, sort of had a breakdown.
Oh, great, great!
Are you sure the teaching had nothing to do with it?
Oh, yeah, yeah, like we had nothing to do with Miss Grimshaw's hospitalisation. Oh, my
Kath,
God!
Kath, come on, these are adults, right? They want to be here, trust me. It's going to be fine. Now, this is your classroom, right? I'm going to be in a room down the corridor if you need me. All right.
Oh, please don't leave me, Stuart. Please don't leave me.
You are going to be fine. All you do is you go in, right, and you introduce yourself, and you get going.
Go on. Good evening, everyone. I'm standing in as a creative writing tutor. My name is Catherine Shand. I'll just... Oh, no, please don't do that.
What?
Well, move your desk forward like that. I mean, I don't want to end up pinned to the wall like some trapped animal, do I? Yeah. Okay. Why don't we introduce ourselves and... you know, give an idea of what it is that we're hoping to achieve. Who would like to go first? No? Any volunteers?
Perhaps you could tell us a little bit about yourself. Your qualifications for teaching this course, for instance.
Yeah, of course. Well, I've just received a PhD in English literature, actually.
What was the subject of your thesis?
Shakespeare.
Shakespeare? The bard himself.
Yeah, that's right. Shakespeare's women towards an understanding of Elizabethan gender politics.
And did you arrive at an understanding of Elizabethan gender politics?
Well, I like to think so, yes. Perhaps you could tell us a little bit about yourself, your name, for instance.
Nicholas Green.
Right. And what are you hoping to achieve here, Nicholas?
Writing a novel.
Oh, well, great. Well, how far have you got?
Well, I'm very much at the preliminary stages. Deciding the right narrative structure. Assessing the various merits of the writers that have influenced me, you know. I've currently got Gertrude Stein and F. Scott Fitzgerald fighting it out in my head. With Hemingway keeping score.
How many pages have you written?
I don't quite see the relevance of the question.
You haven't written a word, have you?
I've not entered the words onto paper phase, if that's what you mean, no.
Right. So you need some help getting started, Nicholas. That's why you're here, is it?
In some sense, yes.
Great. Anyone else?
My name's Rosemary. Well, I'd like some help with poetry.
Thank you, Rosemary.
My name's Russell. I'm a screenwriter. And I'm currently putting the finishing touches to to my script.
Excellent. Or maybe we can start with you, Russell. Could we read some of your script out loud?
No way. Absolutely not. No way.
Oh, any particular reason?
Well, what if someone stole my idea?
I don't think anyone's going to do that, are they?
Listen, this idea's dynamite, okay? It's going to change things. Politically.
Dear God.
Oh, okay, well, maybe we could, maybe you could tell us a little bit about the script without giving too much away.
Okay. Okay. This script is going to blow the lid on a worldwide conspiracy to poison us all with GM foods.
Look, Dad, it's a minor point, but Kath and me, she's not my girlfriend.
What? Whose girlfriend is she, then?
She's with Stuart, the other bloke in the house.
What's she doing with him when she could be with you? Now, that's ridiculous.
Oh, it's a long story.
Now, look, son, you're going to have to sort him out, you know. I mean, he's just wind and piss. You won't have any trouble seeing him off. She might not like it, but she'll respect you for it.
Dad, please, just enjoy your drink, okay?
Right. It's good seeing you, son.
And you too, Dad.
Eat them! Eat them! God damn you, Troy! I will never eat those genetically modified tomatoes. And it's at that point that Henshaw realizes that only he can stop them.
I've actually used a Hollywood paradigm, you see, but I've subtly subverted it.
Oh, my God.
Wait, Russell, it certainly sounds like you're onto something. Could we hear a little more of your script next week?
But I'm only on page 5.
Yeah. Leonard, is there something you'd like to share with us?
No, I'm just having a good time listening to all these clever people talking.
Well, do you do any writing yourself?
No, not me, no, but I want to learn.
Well, could you give us some idea of the sort of thing that you like?
Well, I like the poetry. I like to hear the words.
Great. Well, could you recite a poem for us? You know, something you like.
Okay. This poem is entitled The Bus Home. I hear the cowbell at the tin can school summon me from the steps of my grandfather's house, from an ocean of sweet smells and half-lit lights, from crabs, from crickets, from horizons, from silence summoned, to stand to attention in Brixton in the rain, of course. Here was the promise, the future, the pledge, but where was the number 3? In the distance, a red glow moves closer, larger, like the swelling sunrise above my grandfather's house. I smile to think of home, approach the warm crimson mass, and pay my 70p.
Well, that was lovely, Leonard. That was really lovely. Was it by Derek Walcott?
Who?
Derek Walcott. He won the Nobel Prize for Literature.
No. The Bus Home. I made it up.
Hampstead, please.
But you didn't watch the game last night.
I did, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
It's a bit dull, though, wasn't it?
I thought it was great. I mean, what a back three. I pulled up Sky Stats, and I was so impressed by their defensive record.
I'd chosen the camera behind the goal when that tackle went in. It was definitely a penalty.
I followed their centre-forward on player cam. He made some fantastic moves off the ball.
Well, I didn't see any of that.
You do have a mini-dish.
No, I've got cable.
I thought you'd have the knowledge.
If you're thinking of getting digital TV, get the one with the mini-dish. It gives you more choice and unique interactive features.
Do you want a tip?
Get yourself a mini dish.
Flubbertastic! Catch Bill and Ben's Garden Games video at Asda for $8.99. That's Asda price.
Fresh taste and aroma of Nescafe Gold Blend. Inspiring stuff.
A Bucks Fizz reception, four-course meal, Las Vegas cabaret show and dancing for 2 to 2,000 people from only £27.50 per person. Book Tall Trees for Christmas on 01642 387 100.
Close encounters of the very kind.
We're here to clean the clothes of sensitive earthlings. New Persil non-bio capsules.
Guide you.
Come on! Come on! John! John, it's here! The gas bill!
Okay, so your gas bill may not be that important.
Yay!
But at M-Power, over a million customers enjoy significant savings and thousands more are switching all the time. Because we're constantly working to lower your bills.
If you choose to buy prescription glasses at Vision Express, the cost of a full eye examination disappears. Vision Express, experts with vision.
Okay, first of the tree gets both. On your marks, set, go!
New mini baby bell to go. One for you, one for your imaginary friend.
Okay, do you want to come in now?
Good morning. Welcome to Hot Bible. You can stand on the star. We need a verse, we need a chorus.
These aren't the only people we'll need to impress. Pop Idol, coming soon.
Yourself some breakfast if you like. There's more tea in the pot.
Thanks, son.
Could you have a bit of a tidy up?
Of course.
I'll be at the magazine if you need me.
Now, Eamon, just say no if there's any problem. But would there be a chance that I could see where you work?
I don't see why not.
You sure now?
But you better get your skates on.
Right.
Dabbling father when it seems tradition.
I'm late.
Could I just ask, why are you inviting me to this dinner?
Because various members of the board will be there who want to meet you.
Why do they want to meet me?
Because I've told them you're a very clever young man. Eamon, I can't stress enough how important it is that you make a good impression. There's a great deal going on at the moment, and if you play your cards right, you could be part of it.
What sort of things are we talking about?
I can't say. Just be polite and funny and Irish, and make sure they like you, all right? Yes? Thank you. Your father wonders how much longer you're going to be?
He's just down in reception.
Well, I'll come down. I'd love to meet him.
Oh, off out?
Yeah. Zandra's organised a thing for me to meet some of the board people.
Oh, she didn't come.
He charmed her, so she invited him along too. Cap, do you have the end of a fag?
Yeah,
why do you think he's turned up?
Oh, you know, he probably just doesn't have anywhere else to go.
Well, I don't know. Your father strikes me as a man who's quite comfortable with the company of strangers. And maybe he's here because he wants to get to know you.
Look, Stuart, he walked out when I was 8 years old. He turned up for a couple of days while I was at university, and then nothing until yesterday. Now, you hardly expect me to welcome him with open arms, do you? Christ, this is just too much. You know what hurts the most? The Christmas before my mother died, she bought me this lovely red radio. It was a Roberts radio with the old valves. And when he left, he took my radio with him. That hurts more than anything else.
Yeah, I can imagine. Do you think he loves you?
Stealing your son's radio love?
Well, people do terrible things to each other, especially to people they love. Do you think he loves you? Well, my own father, he didn't. He doesn't love me, neither does my mother.
How do you know that?
They told me. She told me when I was 10. He told me a few years ago. He told me that he'd never love me, never would. See, I can't imagine the comfort of growing up knowing your parents love you.
Amen. Are you ready?
Can't you see? It's an opportunity for you.
Oh, my God. Would you like me to go, son? I mean, I'll understand.
Listen, just get a drink and shut up.
Eamon. And Declan. So glad you could make it.
I was just saying to Eamon that maybe I should leave you to it.
Nonsense. Lots of people are just dying to hear your salty tales. So take your coat off and get yourselves a drink.
Well, if you insist, Sandra.
I do insist.
Right.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Oh, hi, teddy bears. Are you talking to me? Are you talking to me, Troy? Don't worry, you pretty little head, little lady. I'll be back. Do you see, huh? Henshaw finds himself confronting the really big questions. Who was responsible for his father's death, yeah? And then he even starts questioning his own sexuality, which I think, personally, really subverts the action thriller genre.
Oh, really?
Excuse me, do you have a problem?
I think we've heard enough of your silly idea, don't you?
Oh, really, Nicholas? I think that was uncalled for.
Silly, yeah? Huh. I mean, you think it's silly?
If you think Hollywood studio is going to make an action movie about GM foods, you are deluding yourself.
Come on, this is supposed to be a safe environment, you know?
Maybe not. Until they get Bruce Willis on the phone saying he wants to be in it.
Bruce Willis?
Bruce Willis. I happen to know he's very interested in GM foods. And what's more, I know a guy who knows a guy who knows his personal trainer.
Oh, please.
Well, this is ridiculous.
I have something to share with you.
Yes, thank you, Rosemary. It would be lovely if you shared something with us. Please, go ahead.
I... I am a lesbian. There.
Thank you, Rosemary.
One day, I'm in the cargo hold, having a look around like you do, and I make the discovery of a lifetime. The cargo was brandy.
Well, I thought to myself, no one's going to miss a bottle or two. But the thing that I didn't know was that the whole crew had the same idea, all 43 of them, and the captain too.
After a couple of days, there wasn't a sober man on board. Well, eventually we tied up in New York, and the feds, they come aboard, and they discover there's 2 tons of brandy missing. So we were all placed under arrest, couldn't leave the ship. And then suddenly I remembered that when I signed on the ship, I used a false name. On account I'd been having a bit of trouble with the revenue, you know, like you do. So I slipped over the side, and I swam for it. But after about an hour, I clambered up the side of the dock near Springer Street. So there I was, me, with my wet clothes on my back, my passport, and $10 in my wallet. And this old red radio. I put it in a plastic bag. Now, I couldn't have left that radio behind, because it reminded me of home. It had almost drowned me, it had. But it was still dry. And in the coming months, while I wash dishes in some awesome fancy place, the soft, round sound of that radio, oh, was a great comfort to me.
Great story.
I'd sooner remember what I never forget. The steel drum, the women, the swinging, the sweat. The carnivale, the farewell to the flesh. And though I am old, I am not past it yet. For there's a raging thunder in my heart and a carnival spirit in my bed. So next time you pass a dirty old dustbin with a rusty old lid, come closer, much closer. Listen, you'll hear that old dustbin's a steel drum drumming carnival cheer.
I think that's a good note to end on. Maybe see you next week. Thank you.
Hello.
That was lovely, Leonard. That was really lovely. You have got these poems written down, haven't you?
But that's why I'm here.
What do you mean?
Well, I was wondering, when are we going to start the reading and writing?
You can't read or write?
No. That's what I come for, to learn the reading and writing.
Oh, right. Of course, of course. Well, I'd love to teach you to read and write, Leonard. I'd love that.
I memorize every line. And I kiss the name that you sign. And darling, then
from out of the dark ages, a romantic legend brought into the light.
What? Arthur?
In search of the man behind the myth.
But with new Lycos email, sending and receiving has never been...